Broadway to Baltimore. The Hippodrome Theater's behind-the-scenes preview of the 2015-2016 season. Now, from New York's Times Square, Deborah Wiener.
Welcome to New York City, Times Square, home of Broadway and the Great White Way. I'm Deborah Wiener, and for the next half hour, we will preview some of Broadway's best shows coming to Baltimore's Hippodrome Theater next season.
We will visit a shoe factory where everything is not going so well, a record company where things are going too well, and a theater stalked by a phantom. We celebrate 50 years of The Sound of Music, marvel at a 50-year relationship of two friends, and we are voyeurs to pre-World War II Berlin, where life is beautiful.
So relax as we start with Kinky Boots, the winner of 6 Tony Awards, including Best Musical, lifting spirits to new high-heeled heights.
Price and Sons spent the last century making a range of shoes for men. We will begin this century making a range of shoes for a range of men.
Based on a real-life story and independent film, the show is about a failing English shoe factory which turns its fortunes around by niche marketing sturdy boots for drag artists. We follow a struggling shoe factory owner who works to turn around his business with help from Lola, a fabulous entertainer in need of sturdy stilettos. Together, this unlikely pair find that they have more in common than they ever dreamed possible, proving when you change your mind about someone, you can change your whole world. Kyle Taylor Parker, currently playing Lola on Broadway, will be coming to the Hippodrome Theater this September.
I get surprised playing Lola. She is a superhero. She is masculine. She is feminine. She is unlimited. She's funny. She's vulnerable. So I kind of have the challenge to be every woman, every man, so to speak.
This isn't just a show about men wearing women's shoes. I mean, there's a much bigger message here. What do you think the message is?
The message is acceptance, and every single person has permission to be fabulous. You change the world when you change your mind.
I'm not the image of what he dreamed of.
With the strength of Sparta and the patience of Jove, still couldn't be the one to echo what he'd done and mirror what was not in me.
We're the same Charlie boy, you and me.
Inspired by a true story, Kinky Boots features a Tony-winning score by Cyndi Lauper, choreography by Tony-winning choreographer Jerry Mitchell, and a hilarious book by 4-time Tony winner Harvey Fierstein. Don't miss Kinky Boots, live on stage this September.
The hills are alive. All right, I'm no Maria, but The Sound of Music, we all know, enjoyed extraordinary success as the first live television musical production to air in more than 50 years, airing on NBC in December of 2013. Well, 2015 marks 50 years since the movie came out, and in celebration of this big milestone, director Jack O'Brien brings a new production to the Hippodrome stage.
Like any great story, there are several ways of telling it, and we're determined to, I don't think shock people, but I don't mind a surprise or two.
Somebody who has only seen the movie of The Sound of Music is going to be surprised in the very first scene, or maybe the second scene, of the differences between the movie and the show. I know no other situation where the stage show and the movie version are each their own entity and as brilliant as they are.
When The Sound of Music was first written for Broadway in 1959, it was a story based on fact, obviously fictionalized parts of it, that happened in another time. So it wasn't really contemporary, which is, I think, part of why it resonates 50 years later, because it was of another era at the time, and it was written in such a way to make it kind of universal. And on top of that, those songs are pretty great. I mean, you can't beat those songs.
We are putting together a first-class tour that will open in Los Angeles and will play across the country, and I think people are going to be surprised by a lot of what comes out of the show that's always been there. Just maybe look at it a little bit differently.
This romantic and beloved musical story of Maria and the Von Trapp family will once again thrill audiences with such songs as My Favorite Things, Do Re Mi, Climb Every Mountain, and arrives at the Hippodrome just in time for the holidays.
It was sold out in the UK, and now the new production of Andrew Lloyd Webber's Phantom of the Opera is coming to Baltimore on its brand new North American tour.
Critics have hailed this production bigger and better than ever before. This production includes many thrilling special effects, including the show's legendary chandelier, new scenic and lighting designs, new staging and choreography, and the magical score will be performed by a cast and an orchestra of 52, making this Phantom one of the largest productions now on tour. Show producer, Seth Schuyler Hain.
With Phantom, more often than not, we always talk about the fact that it's still running everywhere in terms of London and on Broadway. And as a result, it hasn't been able to be revived because it hasn't actually closed yet. And so this was a chance to take a new creative team and look at the material in a new way. Also, acknowledging the fact that we're 28 years really since the original production in London opened, we're 28 years on. Thus, technology has changed, tastes for audiences have changed, styles of performance has changed. So we've tried to acknowledge all of that and use that as sort of the galvanizing force for why we've reinterpreted and revisited the production.
Turn your face away from the garish light of day. Turn your thoughts away from cold, unfeeling light. And listen to the music of the night.
Don't miss The Phantom of the Opera, coming to Baltimore in January of 2016.
Phantom of the Opera is always good, and this new production even better. Get ready, Motown the Musical is coming to Baltimore. Get your dancing shoes on.
We hope you're enjoying our exclusive look at our upcoming season. Season subscriptions are on sale now, starting at just $181.75 for a 7-show package. Season tickets include the same great seats for all 7 shows: Kinky Boots, The Sound of Music, Andrew Lloyd Webber's Phantom of the Opera, Motown the Musical, The Illusionist, Live from Broadway, Cabaret, and Love Letters. Subscribers also have the first opportunity to purchase tickets to the Book of Mormon and Disney's Beauty and the Beast. Become a subscriber today. Phone lines are now open. Call 800-343-3101 or log on to BaltimoreHippodrome.com. Make sure you don't miss a moment of this incredible season. Call 800-343-3103 or log on to BaltimoreHippodrome.com. Operators are standing by, so call now.
Is bringing the best of Broadway to Maryland, like Baltimore's Hippodrome Theater. Be a part of the history. Subscribe today and enjoy your tickets, your seats, your incredible season of 7 shows. Baltimore's Hippodrome brings Broadway to your backyard. Broadway is yours at BaltimoreHippodrome.com.
Rivers belong where they come. experience one young man's magical journey to be extraordinary. Winner of the 2013 Tony Award for Best Musical Revival. The New York Times calls it astonishing, a Pippin for the 21st century.
Coming to Baltimore's Hippodrome Theater for 1 week only, June 23rd through 28th. For tickets, call 800-982-ARTS or visit BroadwayAcrossAmerica.com.
Who cares what it holds if it can't hold your gaze? Who cares how tight it can turn if it can't turn heads? Who cares how capable it is if it's incapable of creating a reaction? Any SUV can move something, but can it move you? Introducing the first ever Lexus NX Turbo and Hybrid. Once you go beyond utility, there's no going back.
Dirty Dancing, the record-breaking live theater sensation, is finally here. Relive the magic of Johnny and Baby's classic love story live on stage. Spectacular dancing, passionate romance, and all your favorite songs from the movie. Dirty Dancing. Don't miss it. You'll have the time of your life.
At the Hippodrome Theater, May 12th through 24th. Visit BaltimoreHippodrome.com for tickets today.
From Broadway to Baltimore. Now, Motown the Musical is the real story behind the one-of-a-kind sound that hit the airwaves in 1959 and changed our culture forever.
The show charts Motown founder Berry Gordy's incredible journey from featherweight boxer to heavyweight music mogul, who launched the careers of Diana Ross, Michael Jackson, Stevie Wonder, Smokey Robinson, Marvin Gaye, and so many more. Motown the Musical tells the story behind the hits as Diana, Smokey, Berry, and the whole Motown family fight to create the soundtrack that changed America. Motown shattered barriers, shaped our lives, and made us all move to the same beat. Director of Motown the Musical, Charles Randall Wright.
So tell me about the show and what you love about it.
I love everything about the show. But of course, first, it's the music. But it's also such a great story. It's the story of the American dream, that you must go after your dream. And many times they come true. And the important thing is that you go after your dream, not necessarily that you get it. The pursuit is everything.
What was it like casting this show? I mean, because everyone has an image of these iconic figures. So
yes.
How do you do that casting? And how do you sort of trick the mind of the audience?
I looked for people who evoked the energy of these iconic plastic people. And the lucky thing is I had Berry Gordy, who knew who they were before they were stars. So what is it about Diana? What is it about Smokey, Marvin, all of them who came to him as teenagers? So I looked for that energy and I said, don't ever copy, don't imitate. What is that power that they have that makes you think you're seeing this person? And this cast that you have, that you will see, is extraordinary. Extraordinary.
Motown sings its way into Baltimore in March of 2016.
Watch me now. Hey, what?
This mind-blowing spectacular showcases the jaw-dropping talents of seven of the most incredible illusionists on Earth. Audiences will witness death-defying stunts and acts of breathtaking wonder. The show will dazzle audiences and make a believer out of you. If you're ready to be thrilled, mystified, shocked, and astounded, you don't want to miss The Illusionists.
A lot of
sometimes as magicians you're limited by the environments you're performing in, and you don't have the resources to add all this pyro and this technology to it. Whereas, you know, here we are on Broadway with a massive production, you have the capabilities where you say, hey, I have this thing, but in order to do it, I would need this giant, and they go, oh, we have that. And so really the sky is the limit with the material you create. Like those things I did with the LED walls, you know, that's not possible in every show because you need these giant LED screens. So it lets you kind of raise the bar on things that you've seen before and kind of present magic differently than it's been seen in regular magic shows.
It's something for everybody to enjoy, from small children to old people. Something for everybody. Somebody who's really into comedy or appreciates the big illusions.
It's a show really that is completely filled with fun. You're not really meant to come here and think too much. You're just meant to enjoy it. It's an entertainment piece. So some of the incredible things, we make a steam train appear, we make the entire cast and auditorium snow at the end of the show. So it's a complete overview, a smorgasbord of the best magic in the world.
The Illusionist enjoyed a limited Broadway engagement and comes to Baltimore in March of 2016. See it at the Hippodrome before it disappears.
We are at Studio 54, where Cabaret has been wowing audiences with Sam Mendes and Rob Marshall's Tony Award-winning production of the famous musical. Welcome to the infamous Kit Kat Club, where everyone leaves their troubles outside. Life is beautiful, the orchestra is beautiful. Sally Bowles and the Raucous Ensemble take the stage nightly to tantalize the crowd. But life in a pre-World War II Germany grows more and more uncertain. And will the allure of Berlin nightlife be enough to get them through the dangerous times? Costume designer William Ivy Long.
Ari, tell me about Cabaret.
Oh my goodness, this tour is the second Broadway production. It's the first revival. And now we're getting ready to take it on the road again with this new vigor and decadence. And we'll see.
So it's really, you know, when you think of Cabaret, this is not your father's Cabaret.
Or certainly not your grandmother's Cabaret.
How much are you enjoying this particular job for yourself?
I love working on Cabaret. I loved it the first time we did it, and this time even more because we get to try the other things. The things that we didn't have time for are the things that didn't fit.
Tell me again about your connection to Baltimore.
My mother was born there and was raised there, and we go every now and visit the house, which is still there. Of course, it's multi-use now at this point, but she went to Friends School, and then my great-aunt lived there. And her husband, and while the first, through the first production of Cabaret, and she gave me these bins, boxes of things, and I just, in a sort of perverse way, put bits of her clothes and underwear in the original production, which is like the opposite of use that she thought I would put it to. And so Aunt Mary's, and you can look at those early pictures, they're wearing her tam o' shanter, they're wearing some of her underwear. So I just thought that would be a very personal frisson.
The Tony-winning musical about following your heart while the world loses its way. Right this way, your table's waiting at Cabaret, appearing nightly at the Hippodrome, April of 2016.
All right, we're here with Ron Legler, the president of the Hippodrome. It's so nice to see you.
Nice to see you as well.
Electric.
Welcome to Times Square. This is the heart of the universe. We're in the heart of the theater district, so all the Broadway theaters are just a few blocks away from here.
How do you even pick shows? How do you make these decisions?
It's not easy, but what we try to do is we try to find out the buzz that's happening in New York. And we see the shows that are going to be touring, and we try to pick something that sometimes the new shows, sometimes a couple of the classics, and we always like to have a family show or two so we can make sure that all of our audiences in Baltimore get to enjoy them.
Do you feel like a kid in a candy store right now?
I love it.
How can you not?
Right.
All right. So what's the cost?
The cost is the best part about the entire package. You get all seven shows starting at $181.75. You get the same seat for every show, and you're never in a sold-out line. So that's the most exciting part about our series.
I can't imagine doing this with anyone else. We have 40 some odd years of history and that experience of doing Love Story together.
Coming up, love letters and falling in love with Love Story all over again as Ally McGraw and Ryan O'Neill come to Baltimore.
No one else is bringing the best of Broadway to Maryland, like Baltimore's Hippodrome Theater. Be a part of the history. Subscribe today and enjoy your tickets, your seats, your incredible season of seven shows. Baltimore's Hippodrome brings Broadway to your backyard. Broadway is yours at BaltimoreHippodrome.com.
Imagine a healthcare system built totally around you. That's LifeBridge Health. And now we're stronger than ever as we welcome Carroll Hospital to the LifeBridge Health family. Together, we're moving medicine forward and extending our reach to communities across Maryland. For every age and every generation, we'll never stop building bridges to the future of healthcare. LifeBridge Health, the future of healthcare is here.
Rivers Pippin, experience one young man's magical journey to be extraordinary. Winner of the 2013 Tony Award for Best Musical Revival. The New York Times calls it astonishing. A Pippin for the 21st century.
Coming to Baltimore's Hippodrome Theater for 1 week only, June 23rd through 28th. For tickets, call 800-982-ARTS or visit BroadwayAcrossAmerica.com.
Welcome back to From Broadway to Baltimore. Now, Andrew Makepeace Ladd III wrote his first love letter to Melissa Gardner when she was just 7 years old. For 50 years, they wrote letters back and forth through marriage, despair, everything that went on in their life. Who better to tell this love story than the great Ally McGraw and Ryan O'Neill?
When I go to the theater or to the movies, I want to feel something. I do not want to observe it. And the nuances in this, from initial childhood flirtatious attraction to a very deep love that keeps getting skewed, is deeply, deeply moving.
They meet in the second grade and begin a letter writing campaign, which he's very enthusiastic about and she much less, which is appealing to him, the fact that she's difficult even at such a young age. And they chase each other for nearly 50 years.
If you've ever fallen in love with the person who's not on paper the right person to fall in love with, you understand this play, because they shouldn't be together. He loves the artist, the woman who drinks too much, who parties too much, and she's in love with the straight arrow.
I think it'll be interesting to see Ally and I together again. I think that's certainly interesting to me. And it's a very well-written story, and I think they will be moved, and that's my hope anyway.
Well, I can't imagine doing this with anyone else. We have 40 some odd years of history, and that experience of doing Love Story together, which was one of those movies that was a freak success. Nobody knows what's going to happen when you go to work. And suddenly there we were in the middle of this storm, you know. Every single minute was fun and caring, and that doesn't happen a lot. I mean, I did an awful lot of stuff afterwards that, for which I had no real feeling in memory. He's the perfect person for me to do this with.
It's toured a little before, but not as magnificently as it's touring now. You see two first-rate actors, and you see good, straight acting on stage. But I hope the audience invests its own feelings in the story. I'm very excited.
It was great sitting opposite him.
Time stood still. I thought we were back making Love Story.
It's fun, because he's very funny. And really, really, really talented. And the material's great. What's not to enjoy?
Take your loved one to Love Letters, coming to Baltimore, June of 2016. It's been called the best musical of this century. Hello, Book of Mormon is coming back to the Hippodrome.
Hello, my name is Elder Young. Hello, did you know that Jesus lived here in the USA?
The Book of Mormon is an outrageous musical comedy that follows the misadventures of a mismatched pair of missionaries sent halfway around the world to spread the good word. With standing room only productions in London, Broadway, and across North America, The Book of Mormon is truly an international sensation. The Book of Mormon returns to the Hippodrome this November.
Two by two, we're marching door to door, 'cause God loves Mormons and he wants some more. A two-year mission is our sacrifice. We are the army of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
The romantic Broadway musical for all generations, Disney's Beauty and the Beast, is returning to Baltimore. Based on the Academy Award-winning animated feature film, this eye-popping spectacle has won the hearts of more than 35 million people worldwide. The classic musical love story is filled with unforgettable characters, lavish sets, costumes, and production numbers that everyone loves.
As the sun rising in the east, tale as old as time, song as old as rhyme, Beauty and the Beast.
Experience the romance and enchantment of Disney's Beauty and the Beast at the Hippodrome, May of 2016.
Song as old as rhyme,
From the shoe factory in Kinky Boots to the studios of Motown, fall in love with Love Letters and be mesmerized by the Phantom. The Hippodrome is truly Broadway's home in Baltimore. We hope you've enjoyed the journey and will join the Hippodrome family of season ticket holders for a truly exciting and entertaining season. I'm Deborah Wiener. Thanks for joining us.
We hope you enjoyed our visit to Broadway for a behind-the-scenes preview of the 2015-2016 CARE First Blue Cross Blue Shield Hippodrome Broadway season. Season subscriptions are on sale now, starting at just $181.75 for a seven-show package. Season tickets include the same great seats for all seven shows: Kinky Boots, The Sound of Music, Andrew Lloyd Webber's Phantom of the Opera, Motown the Musical, The Illusionist, Live from Broadway, Cabaret, and Love Letters. Subscribers also have the first opportunity to purchase tickets to the Book of Mormon and Disney's Beauty and the Beast. Become a subscriber today. Phone lines are now open. Call 800-343-3103 or log on to BaltimoreHippodrome.com. Make sure you don't miss a moment of this incredible season. Call 800-343-3103 or log on to BaltimoreHippodrome.com. Operators are standing by, so call now.